Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh,
James Thomas is here to tell it like it is. Here to talk education, politics, business. James is here for real talk without the yelling. Real issues and solutions. This is Tell It Like It Is with James Thomas on 1300 WTLS and 106.5 FM. Online at 1300WTLS.com.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this glorious day, for this wonderful opportunity to serve in your kingdom, Lord God, and use you for such a time as this. Lord God, we ask that you compose our hearts and our minds to be on one accord this evening. Give us wisdom and discernment to rightfully decide what is true by your word, Lord God, before this evening. Lord God, we just thank you for everyone that's present. Lord God, we ask that you will be of one accord in love, Jesus. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Council.
Thank
you. Now, for the citizens' request, which was called by the
okay. Yes.
You have to raise your voice.
Good evening, members of the Selma City Council. The main reason for requesting the status was for turning the Selma City Council to the airwaves every day. You know, we'd love to have you guys back home. But of course, as soon as the next council meeting, you're currently not here right now. That's the first council meeting in Denver. And I had an idea that I wanted to share with you guys that might help patch more situations, might be more attractive to you guys. What I was going to propose just to, it seems like at the end of every cycle, broadcast cycle for each year, we run into a renewal, and I know it's time for some of you guys to present every year, so what I was going to propose is actually just take this month-to-month basis, but unless you guys know us otherwise, we just automatically renew month-to-month, and you all set at the top. And if you do so, I would also propose, instead of being a one-time fee that is essentially a big block at one time a year, we just also carry that on a month-to-month basis, essentially divided by 12, and just build month-to-month rather than a single lump sum once per year. I'll make that with cash flow, just as another option to hopefully get you guys back on the air.
Well, thank you, because I know it's very important that we do broadcast the council meeting to keep the citizens engaged. But I know that month is $500, $250 a broadcast. The reason why I know is because I want to get my part on Monday, pay $250. I have another business on until we have $250. Like I mentioned to Paul also, cost of the layoffs and everything. But I'm in favor to listen to the month, and I know I haven't gone out soliciting both the business owners to also get what they can do. We have one or two lined up that would be willing to do it. But $500, $250 per person.
Yes, sir.
Do you mind calling? I count on you.
I'm good, how are you? They're an enjoyable part of the city and from the citizens on the radio station. High quality, everything as far as specifications. You are making it in the city. Thank you. Now, paying month to month, is that more money, less or the same?
It could be the exact same.
The exact same amount, okay, but I just wanted to make sure.
We would continue to, on Mari's main thing, to have a dedicated mission between City Hall and our radio station. We have a contract with Pine Bell Wireless to deliver, and the only use for that connection is, of course, the city council meeting. So we would still pay for that on our end ourselves and make that connection. In addition, we would always enjoy having each and every one of you out on radio station. We also have a little policy still remains.
Yes, you are clear now.
And the access to the airways, we work happy to, because we think it's important that you the rest of the listeners, considering the participation. I think it's really good over the listeners back from that one also. In addition, I'd like to point out that we'll also cross promote city council meetings of all four of our FMs. And, this will be our 10th year here at the council meetings. And, I think we've had a very, very good, reliable service for the city council. And we'd like to do that. Anything else that you think would be important that maybe we could do in addition, we're definitely offering something else if we need to, if you can do a better job with something else.
That's very great. Thank you. Also, are we paying for any other radio broadcasts currently?
Selma City Council?
No, city government. Period.
Yes, ma'am.
What are we paying for?
Okay, there's a weekly show that Mayor Melton does that is actually a program in front of me with all the time on the morning show on WJ, called Mornings with Mayor Melton. Uh-huh. And that is a public affairs program that one of our representatives of the station, I was actually not the station representative, the deal that actually cut that deal. However, that deal is in place now, going on almost 2 years.
And we're paying for that currently, right?
They're just going to see itself.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Councilman Jones.
Well, my question is quality service. Would you guys agree? I still say that that old ball hands up in my mind. The shoes are for my children. As we move back the job, but yet it's still a thing to be fair. We need to go because everyone knows they have lost it. I'll try to.
That's
right. Even though this council, if I go for those meetings, at least they afford an opportunity to come across that side of the city.
Sure.
So I'm going to push for that. You would probably get the business, but I want to go across that side to know that they will come to them as well.
Of course, yes.
Okay, what we would do, we would regress back to last year, and hope we did like we did. And I just hope, everyone wants to broadcast it, they come forward to attend the meeting to hear. We have Councilwoman Bennett, Councilman Bowling,
Councilman Short. Councilman Short, your record should be that. Did you win the meeting for the mayor's office? Was it
beautiful? No, ma'am, in that particular case, it was not. Okay. Well, not that I'm aware of. There was no request, I guess.
You would have probably known. You would have probably.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay. In that particular case, the way that from my vantage point, it was just a block of airtime purpose.
Yeah, but it needs to be deeded up because we deed it down. Because we're paying for that, right? The city plan paying for the mayor's construction.
Yes.
Okay. And I like your offer, by the way.
Thanks, asking. What is the price of the mayor's show on your station?
Yes, sir. Now, please, this, I feel like this is an accurate number, and I can get back to you.
I'll take your best call.
Okay, best call.
Yes.
I'm fairly certain that it's $150 a show.
$150 a show every Friday?
Yes, sir.
And just to follow up that question, the council's retrospective, if you will, that occurs the next morning on Wednesday, does that add to the cost of our total price to hear our broadcast? I don't think it does, but I can answer it for everybody else as well.
Sure. You know, we feel like that it's important for our listeners to have basically a synopsis from the president, or in case he's not able to be there, you know, another representative of the council, but essentially, you know,
that's a thing you're providing for us with no additional charge beyond the cost of actually hearing the city council meeting.
That's correct. It's a factor, you know, it's part of that. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Councilwoman Younger.
Thank you. You know, I love you, and I love the station, and I love the services you give us. So, and I have already, ever since I've been on the council since 2008, Councilwoman Benjamin and personally, I know the three of us have always supported and all the council people are not. It's not always been 100% participating in paying for the show there on the radio, but I know the three of us always have. But now, given how this body quality is and with the things that's going on with us and the way that some of the people who have come up here have acted on the radio just because they felt like they could, and the way that the actions up here have affected the town and everything, I just don't know that I'm just inclined to help support that this campaign. And it is nothing, I want you to do well and prosper. You know, but I just would have to really think about that and see how. I know that the president has made some changes to the agenda and his comment, and has said that we need to hold him out of the fire. And, you know, it's not letting me be in the wrong. But I think that we're really need to know that they're going to do some, I'm going to really need to know. I think there's going to be some changes made, because I'm not going to pay for how many years on that, like we have been. I just want to say that.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
If I don't, that's fine.
Yes, ma'am. I'm sorry. Thank
you. I think I'm a sense of love when you get to Councilman,
I have one little thing here.
Yes, sir.
I have one little thing. Because I was supporting the lowest bidder, and I assisted her to the radio station in terms of the business of the city, and I was prepared to chip in with my discretion there with the lowest bidder. The lowest bidder, I get the job, and Alexander Broadcast is about to get it, so I chipped in. And definitely, you and your family person. I do stand by all broadcasters need to be efficient with the city. And I believe in the little bit process. And they have another broadcaster, they have broadcast service in the council business. And they have made a bid to do the same thing. They will go with them. I know they can get the job. But it was the city of the council, and the city council, who needs to support. I have a problem.
Thank you, Councilor Moore. That's right. Just offset that. Like I was doing, he says the same thing. The reality was we couldn't get any guarantees. Remember correctly, the other radio stations could not guarantee that they wouldn't cut this thing apart, use things out of context to push their agenda. That was my primary concern. I was unable to answer correctly from some of the bidders that occurred here. I obviously agree with you, saving money where we can is a great thing, but If they can't keep things where they need to be and keep it in context, then that's why I voted against them and for this radio station, because they could not guarantee us they wouldn't cut it apart from other than.
And I was not aware of it.
Paul wants to know where they can use him.
Well, I also like to say, maybe one more final statement. You know, if this ends up being the end, as I said, end of the road as far as us broadcasting council meetings, I'd still like to let you know it's very important to us that we, you know, offer y'all access, you know, even if it's on an individual basis, you know, at our station. And please continue to send us, you know, things you have going on, things you think would be important for your decisions to know. By all means, this would not sever our relationship. You know, I just think I want to point that out, that that's important to us, which y'all know that, you know, but council meetings being on WJ, but it's predicated on anything else we made it together.
I want to finally say thank you for staying out of our affairs. You have not been in our affairs. We've been on the radio station. I have not heard you say one thing this way or that way. Thank you for staying out of our affairs and just letting us do the radio station. And thank you for all those free shows that you give us after every single council meeting the next morning. You give us a free show. You give us free airtime. When I voted for a total package, which means I voted for several things. I was looking for several things. You had those things and you had other things as well, including your professionalism and your presentation. So I want to say thank you for that, and hopefully it's not the end of the road. If it is the end of the road, this panel, look for me, and literally I'm down. I'm going to do something for you.
So I guess my final question would be, at this point, what do we need to do to be considered?
Well, basically, I'll be sending out the correspondence to all the local radio stations like I did last year. And apologize. We usually do it at the beginning of October, but they just worried. So apologize. Put it on me. So I'll definitely write it up and type it up and never do it. Since we don't have enough real estate,
thanks to each and every one of you. I really appreciate the opportunity to come before you tonight.
I told you.
Yes, ma'am.
I want to thank you too, because from the time that I have been coming to the Sugar Radio Show, we do broadcast after the council meeting in the morning. Your radio show is very pleasant atmosphere, and you feel comfortable, and a lot of people listen. Some people miss the council show and they enjoy it, and I love coming back, you know, because it makes a lot of
sense. Thank you. Well, Paul, maybe if you have known us, coffee waiting for you to come out.
Our biggest problem is that we didn't have hot prices there.
the mayor, he just sign off, whatever the process is there, and you get it from there. You pay $125, $150, up to $200. This is a permit right here. This permit is 2014. This just so happened to be one of the permits to put my hands on, run it out of the house. And this permit is $183 plus tax, I believe it's $233.12. Now, I applied for the permit, went through the process, went to the police station. I was over to see Lieutenant Fritz. Fritz, yes. It took about a week and a half to actually contact with him, because he's always in the field, understanding he's getting job, or he got the record, whatever, what he was. And finally, when I saw him, he said, wait, he can get back. He said, it took 3 weeks.
I bring us that all up.
Actually, he even talked about it before. About the commitment at the police station. Finally, I called the public captain, he confirmed the public captain process. It goes into January the 7th. Probably when I actually got the commitment. I said, $775. How the world is for me to go from, I know it's a pleasure to know, you know, we have a problem. From $200 to $775. I was on my way to the mayor, and I got a call from the mayor's office saying to me, well, the committee's here as well, because I brought the open and tried to see the mayor, of course, I didn't see the mayor, and maybe I wanted assistance. He said, you'll get it to the mayor, and you got it. We'll call him. The committee's ready. It's $775. So I'm here, they have to say things to me. To ask the city of Selma to please help us. We are a nonprofit, 501c3, and this is all we do. We're not a courthouse, trying to get young people stabilized, trying to get them on the right foot, out of county jail or the state prison or out of the street. Doing the job basically right along with the police, if not locking them up, because that's not our job. So on behalf of the city of Selma, once again, I'm here to ask the city of Selma to give us a reduction for these prices. As it is right now, we cannot afford to pay $775 for a permit by the end of the day, 2 hours. Walking from Brown Chapel Church to the top of King D. Better 65, coming down Alabama, making a left from Broad Street, right there to the foot of Heaven, Heaven Place.
Okay. First of all, have you, how much are you asking us to help you with? And then also, too, Reverend Bowman, let me commend you because you've been doing it for the last several years. But when you're looking at the cost, you also have to factor in it's been a holiday. You know, it's a holiday on Monday. And then you're looking at a lot of the crossing guards are not working. So that's time and a half for the crossing guards. And you're looking at, what, $25 an hour for police officers as well as the crossing guards. $10 per hour. So how much are you asking the council if we could help you with this amount? I would be in support of helping with this endeavor because I know the importance of it, especially with the violence in our community. I've been on board with you since you started, so I definitely would be willing to help you with it. So I guess the council members would encourage you to look at the hard to see what you like to support. Councilwoman Benjamin and Councilmember Shore.
Reverend Bowman, can we compare 2014, please? Thank you. If you want to show me down there, then I'm asking this way. This is this year. I wanted to see that, to see the difference in, because we don't set the amount for officers. They have to make a certain amount when they're off duty. This is why parade permits and any kind of permits concerning safety goes to the police department, because that's their area. I just looked at it, the difference between the number of crossing guards and the number of police officers that the police department determined would be needed. On that one, it says 6 crossing guards, this one, this year says 14 property guards. How many police officers were on this stage? One police officer on that one, and three police officers on this one. So I wanted to compare that to see, this is a huge difference between this year and that one, and Robert's the same as Reverend Paul?
Exactly.
Okay, hold on before you expand, because I know you're anxious. The route is the same, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And I would hate to think that we are doing something different to you all in any way, that we would jack this price up for all these years when it was $100 and something to $200,000. I would hate to think.
$775.
Yes, I heard you, and I see it on this paper. I have the current one in front of me in 2014. I would hate to think that someone has taken this application and decided to give you such an enormous amount of money for the same route, for the same type of labor, and all of those things. So I hope that it's not happening here. It just does not look right to me. This amount of $775 does not look right to me. And all of your paperwork you're saying, this is the comparison, I'm sorry, I meant to pass it down. Councilwoman, someone gave you all the current. All of the other years are the same amount. And this particular year, I don't see, and this is me, and this, I'm not an expert, okay? This is my opinion. I don't see needing 14 crossing guards. 14. I don't see that. I really don't. The officer that I see you would need would probably be in the most track. Would be E. Because you're going to have crossing guards. I think that when you get to the busy thoroughfare, you would need an officer. Which is the one on 2014. And now you have three at $25 an hour. And I guess. Holiday. No, that's very great. That sounds like very great. And so that is why I wanted to compare what you had in your hand to what we have right here. Because I think the amount is ridiculous. It's all in my opinion. I'm not public safety. It's my opinion in comparison one fact to the other fact.
And also, too, before I go to Councilman Short, in the past, we had the prior administration in office. They waived a lot and couldn't even pay.
Exactly.
So this is a new administration, and you have to also take that into consideration. And when you're blocking off the street, you know, there's also blocking off some business that may be open. So that could impede the customers from coming in. But let's see what we can do to help them and put this in there. Have you talked with the mayor about
it?
Okay.
Those are several attempts.
Councilman LeSure?
I truly don't want to again, of course, the change of the police department. I mean, with what they have given is needed. So I would rather for this council just stand it up and just be involved with them to get away and speak. Because this is what the public safety. Well, we should have a team that would be needed for this. Wants to take place. And I know this one is very convenient. It is worth it. You know, the crime in our community is at an all time high. And anything we can do from a council perspective to show support for activities such as this stop the violent movement, I would put the phrase in the meeting about that. But of course, the police department and their estimates are going to be taken to their necessary security for them. People that will be participating in
the
very, very
long. Thank you, Councilman. Your
President Bowie.
Yes, ma'am.
Right now, we are not able to, at this time, that our discretion area, that we can't get any money right now to do it. But I am going to be as a leader with the violence in my area, in my ward, because I have had murders, just had a recent murder on the street. And I have I will try to come up with some money from other, from my, constituents in my work to support this year, because we need to, we really do need what we're trying to do, because no one is coming out in this community taking a leadership to stand out and stop the violence, doing a march. And this is what we really need, to let the young people involved, whatever it is to do, I will come up with some money for this.
Thank you so much.
Reverend Bowman, give us a 10 o'clock in the morning, I have the property law.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
As much more to say, but I think that's fine.
Thank you for that.
Hold on.
You can do it here. Please, you can, safely, quick to think as to the kids, that the courts should have gotten moved to your office,
I give him a call at the end of this meeting. Councilwoman Thomas.
Reverend Bowman, I just want to thank you and concur with Councilwoman Thomas, let you know that you need your number, ex a few of my constituents as well as the personal donation to ensure that this comes to pass.
Thank you so much. The number is the bottom of the five.
I see.
Alright.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir. 10 o'clock in the morning, sir. To the mayor's report, we have Attorney Mayor Harry Everton.
This is definitely not the mayor's report, but I appreciate Councilman Tony putting me on her, Mr. Lewis, and got to get back to me. And you all know that Jim Lewis and Dan before, he is almost on the verge of putting this back in the state government. And as said, you may have all ideas about where he stands, but I thought he'd be able to be a person talking. I don't know this right now, but he may be going to executive session, which he just talked to, but because I don't think that's the problem, and he's not talking about negotiating with the contract. So, it's all right, I'll turn it over to Mr.
Yes, sir. It's yours.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, how you doing?
Thank you for taking the time to review my layout. It's really a pleasure to be back here. Kind of walked me through it. I think it's, but there's a probably short red. I'm sure where there really isn't anything that isn't going to be in the public record anyway. Since I emailed you, spoke to Hilton yesterday, again, they're confirming we're juncture, we're communicating with them about every other day, so they're putting the final details on their franchise committee process. We expect them to get a franchise committee on the 40th month. As soon as they've done that, we will be deeply in touch with you and very concerned to have them back through this. I would say for us, we're familiar with that process. I would imagine that you were not. They don't go to committee for things they're not going through. So this is not something that I'm concerned about at all. We expect them to go forward with that step, from that step, and produce the franchise agreement. Because we have worked with them before, we have negotiated a template that they will echo. So the franchise agreement should come out roughly a week to 10 days after they've their approval. We'll be in a position to execute that. The only other thing that we need from Hilton is called a lender comfort letter, and the lender on project will require that. Basically, assure the lender that we stumble, they can work directly with Hilton, and ensure that the project will be completed and will be allowed. Okay. Do you have any questions about the Hilton side of things before I go on?
Mr. Q, when the call is?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You already know my mistake. Okay, thank you.
Do you want me to be
Councilwoman?
Go ahead.
Please.
I touched on something with me
things that I just touched on here. That's where we're focusing on today.
Thank you. Any other questions from Mr. Lewis?
No, I'd just like to thank him again for his interest in the Radley Group's interest in the hotel, and also thank the law firm that's been there with us the entire step. But,
yes.
Because that's also a Herculean effort as well. And again, some of these went desperately, and I hope and I do believe that this will come to fruition and be the win that some desperate need in our downtown and revival. So I thank you for your effort so far.
We think they're 3 to 4 months out, and it's a fairly rapid process. Getting into some major details, we've got water intrusion that we need to deal with, so there's a fair amount of what I call gutter exterior that's going to be resolving some deferred maintenance that's out there. We've got some health inspects that we need to deal with, particularly on the what I call the 10 back central on the Riverside building. One of the things that we fought for, it took us a while to build in, but I felt that it's very important to maintain the character of the original building, and we have that. And so we made it very obvious service, but we are not changing configuration in the front building. We touched on, again, because of the depth of mechanical equipment, that is the other really significant line item during from basically replacing all that equipment. And of course, you're aware of what works because of the change in refrigerant since those units were put in place. It has the law for the outdoor unit that can help us to replace the indoor and the outdoor unit. Thanks very much for the opportunity to come down. And I do want to say this, I'm thrilled to be here. This is not tough living. This is something that has really become near and dear to my heart, and I'm really finished off. Appreciate your patience, and I'm glad to see that.
Thank you. So basically, to sum up, the insurance company is the building process. If we really need to extend to, we put out here February 28th, and I have a resolution, I know you didn't know it, you know, the consent document next week, that extend it to February 28th, but to be careful, we said further that you as a city council president, together with the mayor, will have authority to extend it beyond that, as long as it's not more than 6 days. So, because you heard what you said, look at this lender, it's a correspondence slave offering place, and they got family, so we got a written law, all of them, and these things can get bought down. He's rare to go and put a year of his life into his technology. So what the resolution will say is February 28th, but the mayor, city council president, acting jointly, president acting jointly, and further planning to extend the project. So when you come back to council, they can tell you something. Then you've already authorized the mayor, city council president, to authorize jointly acting jointly to. There's all kind of purchase agreement and various other.
Thank you.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
Yeah, I can, Jim.
Thank you.
Now to the business order, I'm delighted to have our superintendent in the audience tonight, Dr. Lewis, and Mr. Peterson, and Ms. Harris. Thank you for indulging us tonight. I'm gonna ask Dr. Lewis to do a good push for me.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I gave you a copy of our strategic plan. You may have seen this before, or been to some of our meetings where we were discussing it in detail, but don't believe I've given you each a copy of it. But we are here tonight because we are, of course, interested to see the direction that the council chooses in terms of the tax dollars. I'm presenting the strategic plan to you just as a way to really reiterate the work that we're doing as a school system. You know, when you think about financials, look at assets and liabilities, and when you're looking at investing, you want to make sure that your investments are worthwhile. I present you this strategic plan to show you that your investment is worthwhile by contributing and continue to contribute to the Selma City Schools. We, of course, acknowledge we've got a lot of work to do. If you've been following in the news, we are making progress. And when I say that, I mean in terms of improving academic outcomes for our children. But we're also making changes because we recognize that there's some instability in terms of financial resources for us as well as the city as a whole. At our board meeting on Tuesday night, our board voted to close two schools. This move was put forth because of our need to look at our financial situation and make some much needed adjustments. So we are doing our part to ensure that we're good stewards of tax dollars, and just ask that we continue the partnership and the support that we receive from the city, because it's much needed, and it certainly plays a vital role in our ability to serve the children of this great community. So just wanted to leave you all with that, but if you've got any questions or anything that I can share with you, I'm happy to do so.
Well, first of all, let me thank you, Dr. Williams, along with staff, for the careful effort that you put forth and invested in the future leaders of tomorrow and of today. I know the 17th school system have gone through this transition, but in order for us to be a thriving city, you have to lock arms with the school system.
Absolutely.
The city is only as strong as the school system. And I'm advocating that at least that we move forward to continue giving this amount until the fiscal year, and then maybe we can just sit down and talk and see what we need to do for the next fiscal year. Because, you know, we also talk about what we learn with the young children, the young boys and girls, but it's important that invest in future leaders. And I know it was on Facebook that when I voted no, that I had a hidden agenda. Working at Walter for the last 25 years, I know the impact of lack of funding, how much it can have an adverse effect within the school system. We work closely with Perry County, Dallas County, and also the Selma City School System. There are federal programs that could be drastically affected if these funds are cut. And also foster the retention rate, it plays a big part. You know, unlike some of the private schools, they may not have the luxury of, you know, getting the benefits, but I'm advocating that at least we continue to move forward with this sales tax fiscal year, which starts in April.
I'm going to go back and research the minutes, and
back in 82, it was clear to me that this was a permanent beast war that was operated by the Selma City Council. And at that particular meeting, when it was brought up, even though a vote was taken, it gave the impression that beast war was being extended. That wasn't the case. Because there were several things that should have taken place. And of course, according to the minutes, dated November 19th, 2018, there was more information that he was asking to be brought back to his house. And of course, that amendment was done. But I think it was made on December 7th, and this resource was made on December 7th.
Any other questions? Comments? Councilwoman Youngblood.
Well, you can put it on the consent agenda, but I like to cut it off.
Okay. Okay. Well, this is, yes, and Councilwoman Betts.
After meetings, I absolutely love to hear you. And if you brought the leadership we've given to the Selma City School System, and my vote will not be about the work that you're doing, I concur with that. But just as you did to make our decision, closing down schools, one particular in the area which I work for, those are decisions you need to make based on your budget, based on the items that you need, you are, or things you don't incur, and things that you are experiencing, you have to make a tough choice. And the tough choice here is we lay out 6 million employees. The tough choice here is we don't understand exactly the totality of our finances. The tough choice here is if we don't raise taxes, some say that we won't have a city, we may be in bankruptcy. Those are tough choices that we have to make. And so our first priority is to make sure the city is functioning. Because we're here to represent the city government. And though we would love to support, would love to get in a position where our finances show that we're able to support again, I would support it. But at this time, the things that I'm saying, the layoffs, the potential layoffs that have been stated through the administration that may be impending in March, more layoffs to come, like whole departments of things like, then I would hesitate. I would not be able to be in a position to vote, continue to shut down city government and fund the school system at this time, because if we oppose the government, then the school system is going to be impacted, because I'm quite sure that some of our parents are students in the school system. And so we're here to make tough choices. I mean, because you're a leader and because you're a professional, you know it's not personal. You don't take it away. And we've had discussions about this. And so I would not be in favor of this at this time because of those reasons. If I get the books and the finances are in place and we can give you that $400,000 and more, let's do that, because we want to support our school system and our children. But at this time, with everything we're doing and so much uncertainty, my vote would have to
go. Also, too, I do concur with the Councilwoman Jackson number, but also, we can call it protocol. I mean, if we're going to cut the funding, we should have met them prior to the fiscal year, because the budget is made based upon the sales tax. I don't feel very
hard. Right. We have a budget for FY19. And I definitely understand the tough decisions. Yeah. And you're right, the recommendation to close schools was absolutely a tough decision. But just do be aware that without this funding, we'll be in a similar situation in terms of possible layoffs, which is, of course, that wouldn't support the city either. Maybe it's a no-win situation when you look at it that way, but the funding plays a very major role in terms of how we use school.
Council Jennings for me too. That tax was put on by this council to be given a portion of that tax to the sales of the school system. I know these are I don't see taking money from our children's education to show up where we're lacking in other areas of more business for the city. I think if they're going to be interested, let's look at some other ways and means that we need to educate our children and tax the resources given to them that can be able to.
Also, too, we have a resource at the end of this month that we also need to consider at the end of this, end of January. Councilwoman Thomas. And Councilwoman Thomas.
I love you. Okay. Now, for me, I have to make a I'm sitting here listening, and I hear each of our councilors speaking out about the education of our children. Y'all don't want to give the money for the education of our children. But right now, with the finance situation, we don't even know if the money is there to pay out. We don't know. We do not know. I'm not going to sit up here. If I knew the money was here to be paid out, we are going to have to pay off. And I hear each one of them. And that when it comes to educating for the children, I'm here. But you push it, and we're not seeing the money. If we see something, we don't see nothing. So right now, I'm for the education for the children. But I'm not going to be talking. And I know that if we can't get money for other things to bring the work back, are we going to get the money for, push for the education for the children? And it's being truthful. You know what I'm saying?
Councilwoman Young.
Dr. Williams, I thought we were going to get stuck out with that mouth. Had to address it. Because I'm very thankful. I can't do that. But just of what Councilwoman Jackson said. And I've said it before, probably, even with that conversation tonight. But I'm going to address the Councilman, my good friend, Shelby, my love, and for today, bring this up. And I will say, because I want everyone to know, and I want to remind the Councilman, I have read minutes. I have spoken with council people who were on that council at that time. And I do understand what they claimed that the council's intent was, and how all that came to be, as well as having read the minutes myself. And I understand that they did mean to help the schools initially temporarily, but we were doing so well at that time. We had a full mall, full of stores that were doing well. We had a strip mall across the street that was still doing well. We had a big K and a PQP right there. And, we had all that, so things certainly were different. The city of Selma could be as large as the more generous community, and I hope and pray that we are that way again. I believe that the state of Alabama, in fact, I happen to have personal factual knowledge, the state of Alabama is woefully deficient in our local funding of our schools. And I look forward to the day when we can do better. However, as Councilwoman Jackson tonight has pointed out, and some of my other folks have pointed out, and I have said, we do have to think about our 68 families of the White House Water School. While we did have a commitment that was made back in 1992 to the Civil City School System. Before that, we had a commitment, Councilmember Shore and my fellow council family, to the citizens of Stella to have the streets cleaned, the sewers maintained, the garbage picked up, trash picked up, all of those things. And to the departments that we would have the department staff to maintain, to our workers that we would have, the jobs for them to come to, so long as they showed up like they were supposed to, sober and ready to work and doing the work. So we are not fulfilling our obligation to our citizens, our first and basic responses. If you want to try to compare apples to apples, it would be like as if, we sent it, if the school system brought the kids to school and didn't teach them to read and write and just stuff them in front of big pieces of computers. I mean, we have to get our house in order. And it is anything but in order.
And I am going to claim the day that we can be helpful. Yes, it is a cruel to judge, to just snatch it out and be strong. But boy, we've had everything snatched out. The rope snatched out from under us in so many ways. And we don't have a clue who's in control. We could absolutely go into leadership next week. You know, have the state come in and put us in leadership. Or we might find that money's been squirreled away, like some people claiming it, and have a big stash somewhere. You know, I'm not, and then we don't be happy. But until we know what it is, you get my drift. But we all love food, you know, I love food, I love children. Look, we have the liver in me problem. I love that problem. I'm going to keep giving anybody the food. Food, liver in me. Okay, good. I love that. I just think it's fine. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
And thank you for everything.
Thank you, Ms. Harlan, Alex, and Turkey. Just want to bring to the council attention that the village is 4.7 miles, it's a mile. It's something that they assume to be a
Monday, and then Councilwoman Hughes?
Yes.
Yes.
Right back.
Right now, what is that, when you say, Jeff is saying important?
First and third for the work session.
No, what I was saying is, I thought we had, it was an over, and just deal with the full week, the second and fourth, so don't we need to say before?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay.
The night before.
The night before.
The night before.
So it's a big sandwich of love.
It's just these.
Eight hours, just brush the city council, right? My choice.
So wait, hang on, let's go ahead and do the resolution before.
Dr. Porzenex, Dr. Porzenex. Two days in a row.
Also, two councilmembers, like I mentioned before, we're trying to deal with any fight, everybody going to each community. I mean, I'm committed to the form, in the recommendation that you have, that grant you the case, you go ahead and vote.
Mr. President, tomorrow you have committee assignments for some of the unfinished business that's been brought forward, i.e. the attorneys, i.e. some other things, and get into committees, which are working on those processes.
Yeah.
Sir?
Alright, next. Councilwoman Thomas, please, Corey,
Okay, so, I talked to my committee about this. Yeah, I need you to find out, we need to move forward with our business. The buildings where people, are rent or lease, we're losing, the fund. Wait, Jim?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You said we're losing the fund or on the building?
You know, the buildings, all of our public buildings, the buildings that our constituents rent, you know, people still having things going on and they have a problem. They have a problem of trying to get, the building to have an event at. And I thought that when the last time that we voted, said that some of the councils said that if there's, someone that wants to have an event at one of these, city buildings that we volunteer our time. Okay. And, some people will call me about the Smith building. And, I want to ask you, to find out, because they called down to Terry Davis and they was trying to schedule some events. And was told to them right now that, we haven't got the okay from the mayor yet to start taking in people trying to set up for events and the bills are closed. So, please.
We must have a prayer bridge that we turn the way one.
Yes. And this is why I thought that the city needed money. And if you got leaders, we are leaders. And we agree to. If someone is having an event in one of these places where they have people laid off, so we will volunteer our time to stay there with them to be open.
Okay, I guess if we volunteer our time, I think it would probably be wise to find a way if we want to volunteer our time to work.
Yeah, but you know, you put it, we have put it on the floor, you can do a volunteer. And, you have that was in
the
already. Yeah, we did that already. So what are you saying? We get a form, be it, if we volunteer our time?
Well, my concern is, I guess I like to look at this, the lady, if I was here in contact with the finished, that's not good. Go ahead.
Who's your insurance guarantee?
Well, yeah, the terms, yeah, because that's why we're there, not
that. But we have. Well, that's what I'm saying. You know, we talked for the last meeting. We've been talking about this, and you know, like you said,
I should
keep talking about saving money, and then keep talking about we need to do this. So I'll be back.
Okay, I'll tell you what we'll see tomorrow.
We can't rent ourselves.
You know, we had a little banquet
Dr. Kim a few weeks ago down at the Evans building. And Mr. Robert, who used to work for, but he retired, and he used to work at the Mutual Center. And he can do the contract work if this is okay with the city. He knows exactly what to do, that's what he needs to do with public evidence. He did, that's what he did. You know, we hired him, and he is a contractor, just, you know, the person that was doing that, hired him as a contractor, and they had a caterer, they had him to do the help, so to step up and do the setup, just like they used to do. So that would be somebody. If, you know, I don't know how that would work if they just work with a contractor. So we know what they need to work with the other two and things like that.
And also, President Boyd, will you check and see if the any check has been paid out for some of this, where the air conditions and things have been taken out, the ceiling feeling and everything? You know, they said they had taken the air conditioning out, and you know, we don't need the air conditioning now because it's cold, but it's still, you know, it was the insurance, it was covered under the insurance, because they got plastic over here now. So, I would like to find out if they have paid them, and what are their plans, are they going to go, what are the plans?
Okay. Well, while we're on the, we got Ms. Jane from the top right over here, and she's talking about that, and isn't that what you're talking about? I'm sorry, I got too much on my face, Mark. Well, I saw Ms. Candy, I say, and I'm
well, they don't wait. Everything is rolling.
Yeah, I know. Could you, at some point in the next couple of weeks, maybe find out what we can anticipate for going on in Dallas Academy, given that I am missing so many?
Because the bid has already been out, and Mr. Pete gave me, I went by his office, gave me showing the bid process, and all the information in there that I've been reading over a lot of the Dallas Academy. Now I'm just waiting on.
My question is making sure that you know what the plan for the physical plan.
Well, he did tell me that Sheriff Pete did tell me he's gonna keep me updated and informed on that.
Good.
He did tell me that. That's why I gave him the staff fee.
So they supposed to run in the Montgomery Avenue.
It's already been
here.
Has that goes down the floor?
That's all I'm dealing with. And I would like for you to please, you need to know something because people are trying to get you to build it. And if we can, we talk about saving money and we turn away money. Can you find out if we are allowed to
start planning weapons and stuff?
Next thing on here I have, the traffic light. For about 2 years now, I have two traffic lights. And I want to know how, do public work order the traffic light?
Do they have, what's the town center?
He's been doing ain't working. He's been coming out in the next 3 weeks, the light go back out. He's been doing it for the last 2 years. I have two traffic lights. There's one on First Avenue and Church, and the one on Ella Anderson in Church. We've been dealing with these two traffic lights for the last 2 years, and I'm thinking that with the way they look, they kind of go out. I'm trying to see, can we replace those two, get some new ones to put up in? If they have it, because I haven't seen put up any new ones in my budget.
I think we have money in the budget in mind.
Because they go out every week, and I've seen some bad accidents that happen in the area. On church, and Delta Anderson, and on church in First Avenue.
So we have one.
No, sir.
So,
I have one more.
Go ahead.
Can you get Brian out with the fee? Have we approved the fee of the public building going up? Because the lady was trying to plan. She saw me in Walmart. She said she had called and it was told her and the fee of the building that we rented out or going up. So can you find out the fees up?
Oh, well, basically, we get a copy of the contract, the fee's still on the number.
Yeah, you would know if the fees have gone up because you would have voted on it. I know that that's why I told her we didn't vote on it. So unless she was referencing when we increased the fees some time ago, maybe 2016 or 17, unless she's referencing, unless the person was familiar with the old fee, and she was talking about the most recent passing of the fee, there is no increase. Because the increase will have to come through you, I, and everybody on this panel. Council says the fees for public buildings, period. So it can't come from anyone else. So you would know there's an increase because you would have to vote on it. So that's what I told us. They're talking about the increase that happened 3 years ago. She's talking about recently. Oh, no.
That's all. Check on this one.
All right. Yes.
Kimberly, 2019, I put before each of you a copy of the final meeting document. Back here last year, Councilor Lee, Council President,
myself and the Treasurer, Ms. Wade, Officer Thomas, and members of the Jubilee Committee, and we discussed several points in the case of the resolution and committee, of course, we met twice, it was supposed to be the meeting in September, and we kind of heard of our budget here. I contacted the chairman of the Bridge Crossings Jubilee on this building, and I spoke with her to ensure that my folks' aggressions and my notes from those meetings were, in fact, what she remembered and agreed on. I sent notes to you all on yesterday and to review. So that, you know, if I had omitted anything, that was, I know there were some small things, but we're looking for a vote to go ahead and ensure that they have the approval they need to get with the police department to use kind of the traffic crossing and the next one. But the points of discussion and the points that we're looking for to be voting on, one, access from Broad Street to Lawrence. If you recall, they were willing to move and to the east side of Ward Avenue. So you're looking at those that they were on Ward Avenue, starting across the Street, right at the bridge, going all the way down to Lawrence. You know that is the street where Spillers and the Evans building and those things are. Access to the Evans building and Everett building was what's the discussion that we had at that time. I'm not sure. But that will be because they weren't closed at that time. I recall them asking for educational items at that time to do things in those buildings. I did speak with her and reminded her that they don't do drugs and or vendors if allowed in the park. That is not really allowed in that area or the surrounding side. Also, they would have gates at Washington, Frank, and Greensburg, and Lawrence, before no traffic.
be in the area. And they're asking that, and I'm starting to get that, and both my students, President, or, Councilman Johnson, saying, you know, it's his area, that it is in the area, they've been over there, they become traffic, additional traffic, and we're in the area, and we're like, and also, you know, the cell towers, wanting to ask them, storage, so that they know that this would be the main area of the community. They didn't speak or try to talk about what happens if the Jubilee brings over the next, which is coming back in. If the Jubilee here is going to be St. James, so I actually, get through, 2019, because it is not something that we get, and was immediately after, so it was, necessary to be looking at 2020. But if, these are things that they would like to follow. Also, I confirmed with Council Council Protean that they paid a fee of $5,000, last year for access, for additional, officer and crossing guards and things of that sort. And one of the things that he said, in our meeting was that they may not need it, need a crossing guard, to ensure someone's safety from one end of the border entering to the other, kind of across on the off-road bridge and making sure that no child is ran out of the moving traffic is not something that the city could have to protect necessarily because we would not be, they would not be allowed to cross back and forth other than as pedestrians who are kind of at their own risk and by the side. So, they've also asked to look for public works and for slow traffic signs to try to speak with them about what's going on for you all and see what the mayor and council board is concerned with and how we can all like to see. It was not as, the first meeting he said that he could, I may go over the second meeting because he wanted to be there, I'm not available for the second, and the third meeting. I did email them with this on this man, and I found out today, contract wins and so on, the pressure that he has not had the opportunity to be here. I named the initiative with, President, Protean, myself, Ms. Bernie McWayne, Dina Phillips, and all of her. Off the top of my head, I remember Sergeant Thomas being there, Selma Alpha being there.
Some of these people that have been on the function of the city,
think it would be a wise thing for the future to bring the people to be committed so that we can get on the same standard. That would be my opinion. I think we just put I think they need to be a meaningful official outlining what the expectation will be for this upcoming year.
Okay, and that's, if I'm allowed to finish, on January the 11th, I met with the chair of the Bridge Crossing Jubilee, Ms. Sabina Phillips, and I said, what is your understanding and what have you all voted? If you recall, they said that they were going to go back and vote as a committee on the things that they agreed upon. And these are the things that they've agreed upon. This is their understanding. And I've asked her to be present for Tuesday meeting, seeing as though she's the chair of the committee and she should speak for the committee. I don't see where it's necessary to have another full meeting. Everyone was invited to the last meetings that were held. And I think it's imperative that we get this done on the 22nd of January, seeing as though February is coming and all we have is the first week of March. And you recall, Mr. Kevin Bowen stated just tonight that it's been 3 weeks to get in touch with anyone to get things said at the police department. So if they have the same, you won't have this information in place for them. And our vote is imperative for them to move forward.
I understand that the call of the problem that we have experienced with the Jubilee over the past 30 years. That's the last time y'all met, they made a last year.
No, actually the last time we met was July of last year.
What's the same way?
And the final meeting was January the 11th of this year with their chair.
Just the chair?
Yes. What? But she has the meeting minutes from them stating what they agreed upon and what, based on our meetings, what they were willing to accept. Ultimately, it's our decision.
That's true. Departments that they were worthy that they take every year that comes. So people who struggle to ensure that people of color have the right to vote. Let's present that thing. It will be fine for a meeting to take place, not only with the chair of Jubilee, but with the entire committee so that there will be problems that will be handed out, waiting out, there will be no problem leading to the celebration of March 7th. That is my recommendation.
Okay. According to roll call, I think we hashed out a lot. And I mean, a lot. It was a very cordial meeting. Everybody understood the move. Everybody was in agreement with the move. I don't remember any adversity to it. I don't know what information would change because a couple of people are no longer with the, well, I don't know if they were serious or not, but I don't know what information would change. And the chair came and represented this year for the committee. I mean, I know Ms. Billis. She's not the letter. I don't know what would change because someone is on
furlough. I'm going to suggest if you don't do what you want to do, anything you suggest, any difficulty, have this represented for these to the coordination of the fact that you're a man there today. I think it would be wise to do our same thing for a couple of months off. It would be wise to be for the entire community committees. Along with the city officials, hand out this MAP saying, what is normal have occurred?
What I'm saying is that we did iron out the irons there were ironing. We ironed out at those meetings, so we met in May and July, and y'all know the bottom dropped out of the city of Selma in September, it was supposed to be in September, when the bottom dropped out. There was a lot of ironing out at this table down here, I mean, a lot of ironing out.
Let me read off to you the things that were discussed, the things that were recommended, and the things that were agreed upon.
Right.
Okay. So, five roles presented the following. Volunteers, and mostly, that if they are volunteers, there's no pay, and they're mostly different.
that Montgomery Bridge Reverend who collaborated on it, and she also shared documents on past. She presented, there was a presentation, but it kind of, city came time, and there was draft, but they did not even comply to this. Councilwoman Jackson indicated that lodging is not reflected in the exodus way through voice and audit for campus. Julie's recommendation, do not take the $5,000 donation that you did there. Their recommendation was to become a part. Their recommendation was not to increase the $100 vendor fee this year. And the recommendation was a location change. Their recommendation was a location change. They agreed upon the recommendation. That was the entire committee agreed on this. And these are the things that they stated in their meeting. We agree. However, we have to take that to our board. One, location change. Two, Broad and Lawrence. Amphitheater at no cost. Evans Building, partnered under the education committee. Paying online, they're being paid, and this is being moved to a welcome reception. That's the thing that we agreed on. Now, the city's not in a position where we can handle a welcome reception, or any of it at this point. So, the points that we agreed on was access to Broad and Lawrence, same thing we initially agreed on. Access to the Evans Building and Amphitheater. Same things we initially agreed on. No food trucks or vendors in the park and surrounding sidewalk. Same thing. And letters to business underlining the move. They have also said they're willing to pay their $5,000 fee, which what they're essentially doing is giving us back the money we gave them. I don't understand. And they're going to be here to somebody who can question them as much as like they should like. But I will say this. I've taken the time to meet. I've been at every meeting. I've taken time to ensure that I had a meeting without you all to discuss the final points to make sure that when I presented as the head of the Jubilee Committee, that I did not provide any erroneous information. If there is to be such another meeting, it will not be based on my schedule. I will make my take out of my time frame because I've done my due diligence and if Mr. Assure Council Assure, with all respect, if you would like to take over that committee, by all means.
Hello. Can we just put it on the MOU based on this low bar sign and move forward?
I have that problem.
I don't want you folks to hear it. I just want to hear on some of the problems. First, say that. Mayor Curley, even in your correspondence, you list higher needs to look for fee approval and pay.
And I stated to you that it was confirmed by Councilwoman Hilton that the $5,000 work was done. Did I not ask you to confirm that? No. I did. Those are notes to myself on this discussion.
Okay. So the last time we met was back in July. So if they don't mean to let me kill you, they
have a problem. Let's say one thing.
But if they are a problem, period, don't say you never.
Okay. Also, too, to help, you know, probably expedite this Councilman Chua, if you just did the MOU between both parties, we sign off and go forward from there. That's all I
have. If you recall, Councilman Curry, you met the day before the last meeting, and there were incurred problems. We had a move, we had statements made. I walked in my high heels from years to Board Avenue and all the way back. And so we can't get off every issue. We're the ultimate, and we're the body that's going to decide.
Just on this part, I'm being surprised, Councilwoman. Would you add a number eight? You know, we talked about the Phoenix Park for storytelling for children. You feel like I can write yourself notes. You happen to include your notes on here. So that's what I do. And I remember that my assignment was Angela needs to make sure that she's available to help with the storytelling team. And I think I agree to that. If my schedule was available, and I think it is, and that includes the previous part. Just so I'm getting a
Actually, we told them every part. So we talked about the children and we talked about the Phoenix part and Butterfly part.
And we're out to lunch.
Right. Okay. And what we say is the multiple ones that was there.
their area that weekend, and that we didn't necessarily take down and say, this person is going to have it weekend, but that's, we're not going to allow anyone else to have that area during that weekend. But yes, we need to get to the, yeah.
So can we just have that on?
I'll speak with Ms. Phillips at four, she came out of my office last Friday, I asked her to come down to the university, and she does not, we don't talk on that title or something, and she should be here.
Can we both just sign that on, just put it on the set?
Yes, and I sent it back to her all again. Alan said it's all council before today, but I was waiting to hear that from you all.
And I invite my business, I told him
he's on the business, so, financially, accountable, so this, you know, this we can get out of this thing tonight.
They might arrive, you can arrive, they go always, this will tackle a lot of them.
Okay, Councilwoman Thomas.
I want to ask you, remember the other, did they ever get theirs coming back?
No. Yeah, we're just sending the invitation to the government, also.
Hopefully, they're.
Yeah, they agree with you.
Starting in 2020.
2020.
2020, hopefully. Yeah, great, that's just great.
But we offer them same thing, they offer to the community.
Because I know, first one was in the other branch, so Mr. Hannes, I've got time now, but, things didn't materialize, so hopefully we can still extend courtesy, hopefully we can get some money.
Financial accountability, so I sent you all the email and requesting those documentations, and I spoke with our president for the team, and she said, July 4. I know that in the legal community body, that we're not in the business, citizen, we're body, and so we don't have to be there for people. Spirit of residential partnership, I do that.
It is part of the minutes.
Part of the minutes.
That I signed off on.
Yes, sir.
And the mayor signed off on.
Yes, sir.
So he's confirming that the minutes are accurate. So now we still have to get the form.
Understand what practices they have in place. How they're doing it, I can be better to understand
the policies of the city, we can help them develop and make them more, and we never read it, or if they never apply it, we would use their tip.
But I just would say, because I had someone already looking at that, Montgomery and Huntsville.
Okay, so I have a number, you can take that off.
What do we have?
By finance, I will get the consultant.
Because I sent the, I sent it to friends of mine, about the Montgomery and Huntsville, who basically, you know, go out and audit from this kind of story.
So if you need that, I will partner with you, and you know, my discretion, your funds, to get that done, and be really, make sure we have those internal consultants. We're, they have started the next budget, the last commission that I was able to obtain, that I haven't started. But we're doing the same thing that we were doing previously, and we're gonna have, not only six, one final, we're gonna have more, because we don't have that part person in there saying, this is not right, you need to do this, we don't have an actual head, I don't believe.
Well, the thing about them, they're Catholic, I prayed to the Pope, so this firm in Montgomery and Huntsville, that fell a Catholic, so they know that pro bono for them. Captain LaShaw.
Yeah, I love you.
So if the government had to move, he could put on the center temple.
Okay.
Everybody's had to sign off on it. Alright. We can turn.
I'm sorry, guys. Hey, I brought these for the council, but she's in my house.
And you have to pay her.
Edit this stuff and get it on my hair.